Hi and welcome dear students. Today we are going to read a short story that is When Wishes Come True. It is written by Rabindranath Tagore and it's an interesting story between the dream of a father and son. It is based on wishes that when someone is young, he prefers being older so that he can have more liberty and he can change his life. He will have more command over his life. And when someone is young and is subjugated by the parent, that person wants to make he wants to grow up faster and older. But at the same time, when someone is older and he looks at the younger generation, he thinks of revisiting his childhood and reliving those actions, those moments that he has missed out while he was young. This story is something similar of that nature, that father and son wanted a different life to what they were living. And as they experienced that changed life, it so happened that their wish was granted true. They happened to see that kind of life and they regretted and they wanted to go back to their life and live the moment that God has given them. Let us read the story and develop a better understanding and delve into the main idea and details. The objective for today's lesson is to identify the main idea and details. And at the end of the story, after question answers, you are expected to arrange the events of the story in the correct sequential order using transitional words. So as the story is being read, kindly make a note of the main events in your notebook so that you will have some ready reckoner to refer when the pictures are shown to you. Let us begin with the reading. When Wishes Come True by Rabindranath Tagore. The son Sushil drove the entire neighborhood mad with his antics. Antics means tricks. This made his father itch to punish him. Unfortunately, the father suffered from rheumatism. Rheumatism is an illness of joints where the joints begin to pain. It is mostly, it is not generally related to old age, but any person from any age can suffer this. It is an ailment of joints, referring to pain. While the son could run like a deer. Now, like a deer is a simile. Kindly make a note of this in your notebook as you're listening to the story being read to you. So most of the intended slaps missed their target. Whose intended slap was that? It was the father's intended slap, and because the son could run very fast, so he could run out of the house, or maybe he could dodge his father. But on the rare occasions when his father managed to catch him, Sushil really had a bad time. Had a bad time means he received beatings. We proceed with the next to the next paragraph. That is, the day on which the story begins was a Saturday, and the school would be over by 2 in the afternoon. But Sushil was in no mood to go to school for a number of reasons. So you can make out Sushil did not like going to school. Kindly make a note of it. But Sushil, to start with, it was the day of the dreaded geography test. Dreaded means disliked and fearful geography test that he wanted to avoid. There was to be a display of fireworks at the Bose's at evening. That evening, which everyone was looking forward to. Sushil too longed to spend the day watching every bit of the preparations. After thinking long and hard about it, Sushil jumped into the bed while it was time to go to school. Subal looked at him. Subal is the father, okay? Subal looked at him in surprise and asked him, "Why are you still in bed? Aren't you going to school?" "I have a terrible stomach ache," said Sushil promptly. "I can't go to school today." Subal saw through the trick at once and said to himself, Very well, I know how to teach you a lesson. He turned to Sushil. A stomachache, huh? You would better stay in bed then. You're not to go anywhere. I had bought some lasagnes for you, but you would better not have them. Just lie down quietly while I go and prepare a brew for the stomachache. Brew means something to boil. He's gone to now make a preparation for his stomachache. Okay. Subal locked his son in and went off to prepare a bowl of a really bitter brew. Sushil was in a quandary. Since he was thinking what will happen. He loved lozenges and loathed anything bitter. That means he hated anything, that he didn't want anything bitter, especially the brews his father made. And he was dying to go to the Bosses. Bosses is the place where the firecrackers would take place. But now these seemed to be no chance. Then Subal returned to the room with a big bowl of bitter brew. Brew means something boiled. So Sushil jumped out of the bed saying, I am fine now, my stomach aches has gone. I'm going to school. You're not going out anywhere today, said Subal. Bring this and lie here quietly for the rest of the day. He forced the brew down Sushil's reluctant throat. Reluctant means unwilling. Locked the door from outside and left. Sushil burst into tears and wept buckets the whole day long. Wept buckets means he wept a lot. He told himself over and over again, if only I could be as old as my father, I would be able to do whatever I wanted to do. No one would be able to lock me in like this. So now he wanted to grow and become liberal and do whatever he wanted to do. Right now he was being subjugated by his father. Supal sat outside and thought, my parents pampered me so much when I was young. Now this is the father thinking. I could never study as much as I thought I ought to have done. If only I could be young once again, I wouldn't waste a single minute playing. I would spend all my time studying hard. Now Supal, the father, wanted to become young, so who could go back and study, while the son wanted to grow older so that he could be liberal and take decisions himself. Now let us see what happened. And it so happened that the goddess who grants wishes was passing by just then. She heard both Subal and Sushil and decided to grant them both their wishes. Appearing before Subal, she said, tomorrow morning you will be as young as your son. And to Sushil she said, from tomorrow you are going to be as old as your father. Both father and son were delighted. Usually old Subal could never get any sleep towards the early part of the night, but around dawn he was fast asleep and slept late. But when the sun rose the next morning, he almost jumped out of the bed and discovered that he had grown quite small. The teeth he had lost were all back. His mustache and beard had vanished. The clothes he had been wearing were too big for him now. His shirt sleeves were longer than his arms and almost touched the floor. The neckline reached down to his tummy, his dhoti swept the floor and he almost tumbled in it. Kindly make a note of this paragraph. It is a physical description. This is how description is written. Sushil normally woke up at the crack of dawn. At the crack of dawn means very early in the morning when sun is about to rise. And ran about the house, but this morning he was hardly able to open his eyes. When he finally did succeed in shaking off his sleep, It was only because his father was making such a racket outside. Racket means such a lot of noise and trouble outside. Sushil woke up to find that his clothes were really tight. Now, so who is Sushil? Sushil is the son, and son is now grown older. His body had become strangely bloated. Bloated means swelled up. Nearly half his face was covered with a salt and pepper beard. Salt and pepper means black and white. That means he had grey hair on his beard and moustache. There was no trace of any unruly hair that had covered his head. He was shocked to discover a gleaming bald pit in his place. That means now his head was bald. He had no hair on the head. What seemed even stranger was that he didn't want to get out of the bed as he did on other days. Now he didn't want to come out of the bed. He yawned, turned over on his side and decided to stay in bed. Both father and son had got exactly what they had wished for. What they had not anticipated were the complications. That means when the son's mind is young but body is old, will he act in the same manner as older people do, or will he still act like a child? And the son and the father, whose brain is older, more matured, and now he has been given the body of a young child, will he behave like a young child, or will he still behave like a refined or matured person? So now comes the complications. In the past, Sushil had always thought that once he was old and independent, he would spend his entire time climbing trees, swimming in the pond, eating raw mangoes, looking for birds' nests, and roaming wild with the friends all day long. He would return home only when he felt like it and eat whatever he wanted to. There would be no one to stop him from doing what he wanted. When he woke up that morning, he felt no urge to climb trees. He looked at the pond covered with water hyacinths. These are plants, water plants, and felt quite certain that he would run a temperature if he darted to take a dip in it. He spread a mat on the veranda and sat there lost in thoughts. Finally, he decided that he shouldn't give up the things he was fond of. He stood up and decided to try his usual antics. He went to a nearby olive tree, made several attempts to climb it. He was astounded to find that climbing a tree was beyond him now. Wasn't it just yesterday that he had been up there as easily and effortlessly as a squirrel? After several attempts, he hung on one of the lower branches, which gave way means broke down under his weight and broke into two. He lay flat on the ground. Passers-by were amazed to see an old man trying to climb a tree, and when they saw him rolling on the ground, they burst out laughing because they couldn't understand that what has happened to this person. They thought of him as an old man, but it was not an old man. It was Sushil, whose body had grown older. Now, Sushil's friend, who had played with him just the previous evening, took one look at the grouchy old man and ran for their lives. That means his friends ran away. They didn't want to play with him. They had no idea that it was Sushil himself. Sushil used to think that the moment he was old and independent, he would play with his friends all day long. But now the very sight of Gopal, Akshay, Harish and Nanda put him in a bad mood. He hated the thought of their noisy games and didn't want them to disturb him. You'd remember, of course, that once upon a time, Subal had told himself that if he ever got back his lost childhood, he would lock himself up in his study and pore over his books all day long. He would even give up listening to grandmother's stories at night and would learn all his lessons in all earnestness. Now he was young again, and that he was young again, he hated the very thought of studying or going to school. Sushil was very angry with him and said, "Father, aren't you going to school today?" Subal looked down, scratched his head and said, "I can't. I've got a stomachache." Now see, the situation has turned upside down. The father is making the same excuse which the son used to make. And now the son is asking the father, wouldn't he like to go to school? Let's see what happened. "Stomachache?" said Sushil angrily. "Don't try your tricks on me. I used to get a similar stomachache to avoid going to school. Don't try to fool me. I know all about it." Sushil had known so many different ways of playing truant, and the memory was still so fresh in his mind that it was quite impossible for his poor father to fool him. Sushil forced his young father to go to school. When Subal returned in the evening and longed to go out and play, it was time for old Sushil to wear his glasses and read the Ramayana aloud to himself. Subal's noisy presence disturbed him, so he made Subal sit in front of him and do the sums. He selected such tough and complicated problems that it took his young father more than an hour to solve at least one of them. In the evening, Sushil played chess with the old men in the locality. Sushil was particularly careful about food. When his father Subal was an old man, he had a lot of digestive problems. The slightest overeating would bring in an attack of acidity. Sushil remembered it very well and stopped his young father from eating his fill. Eating his fill means eating to his satiation. Subal, on the contrary, was perpetually hungry these days and felt he would be able to digest even a piece of stone. However, Sushil just would not allow him to eat normally, and Subal remained hungry. He started losing weight and growing thin. Sushil was afraid that he was really ill and made him swallow all kinds of pills and powders. Old Sushil also had his own problems. He soon realized that nothing of what used to be his second nature suited him anymore. Earlier, he had been so fond of plays that whenever he heard of one being performed, he would land up there. But when he tried to do the same now, he fell sick. The irregular hours gifted him a cold cough and severe body ache, and he had to remain in bed for 3 whole weeks. Now, old Sushil, what do you mean by old Sushil? The father, who was Subal, now he is the son, Sushil, isn't it? Now, he wanted to act like the younger son, but his body wouldn't allow him, or his mind wouldn't allow him. He couldn't do what he wanted to do. He wanted to play, but he couldn't play. He wanted to watch, but he couldn't watch things. He fell sick, and his body ache was quite troublesome, that he had to stay in bed for 3 whole weeks. Young Sushil had loved to take his daily dip in the pond, but the moment he tried it now, his rheumatism increased so alarmingly that he had to see a doctor for 6 months. Now, if you know that Sushil has become older, and now his body is old, and rheumatism means the problem of the joints. When he touches water, it troubles him, it gives him a lot of pain. He now bathed at home in warm water, and that too on alternate days, and refused to let Subal bathe in the pond as well. Every time he tried to jump out of the bed the way he did when young, his old bones would rattle more uncomfortably and send soothing pains all over his body. When he tried to pop a pan inside his mouth, pan is the betel leaf, in his mouth, he used to do, he realized that no longer had any teeth to chew with. He would pick up the comb by mistake to comb his hair and end up scratching his bald pit. If you remember that now he has become bald. He has no hair on his head. Subal too forgot at times that he was no longer old. He would go and join a gathering of old people and comment on their discussions. Needless to say, it would annoy them very much. They boxed his ears, scolded him for being precocious and told him to go away. Forgetting that he did not look old, he would ask his tutor for a puff of tobacco. The tutor caned him soundly and made him stand on one leg as a punishment for his impertinence. He forgot his new look once again and asked the barber why he didn't come to shave him anymore. The barber thought he was joking and replied, "I will in another 10 years or so." Sometimes Subal would go and smack Sushil as before. The elderly Sushil would flare up and say, "Is this the kind of manners they are teaching you in school these days? How dare you?" Enough was after all enough. Subal now prayed with all his heart that he might regain his lost age and independence, which he had been foolish enough to pass on to Sushil. Sushil too prayed earnestly that he might become young once again and play around with his friends the way he used to. "Father has become exceedingly naughty. I can't look after him anymore. He really worries me all day." The goddess who grants wishes heard them both well. She said, appearing before them, "Are you satisfied?" "Yes, yes, indeed we are," cried both father and son, falling at her feet. "Please change us back to what we used to be once again." "Very well then," said the goddess. "That's what will happen when you wake up tomorrow morning." The next day, Subal woke up as an old man and Sushil found himself young once again. Each of them felt that he had just woken up from a bad dream. Subal raised his voice and asked, "Sushil, why aren't you studying your grammar aloud?" Sushil scratched his head and replied, "Father, I have lost my book." Let us proceed to question answers. "But people are not always true to their names. Is this a statement true about Sushil and Subal? Explain." Yes, the name of Sushil and Subal do not do justice to their two people who bear those names. Sushil means well-behaved, but the real Sushil in the story is not well-behaved. On the contrary, he and an impish child who told lies to his father. Similarly, Subal means very strong. He has a very weak body and is suffering from rheumatism. Why was Subal not able to correct Sushil? Sushil was so naughty that he drove his entire neighborhood crazy. Although Subal tried to punish the young boy, Sushil always got away because Subal was too weak to run after the quick-paced Sushil. Whenever Subal tried to slap the boy, Sushil easily escaped his father's unsteady blows. Why did Sushil wish to take an off from the school? Hence, Saturday half-day geography test he dreaded, feared, had planned to see the fireworks at their neighbor Bose's residence. All his friends were looking forward to it. These are the guidelines or outlines given for writing the answer. It will help you write the answer, but it has to be written in a paragraph in complete sentences. Was Subal a good father? Give reasons to support your answer. No, Subal was not a very good father, although he shows some raw traits of a good father. The relation between the father and son doesn't seem to be very healthy. Subal's methods of punishing his son appears rude and cruel. He should not have resorted to beating all the time. How did Subal punish Sushil for lying to bunk the school? The hints are given over here. The sweets he wanted to have, lozenges, and tempted Sushil. Instead, he gave him a bowl of bitter brew, locked him in. You need to take these hints, consider it, and write the answer in your own words, in complete sentences, in a paragraph. Why did Sushil wish to be an old man? Sushil wished to be an old man because he wanted to become liberal and take his own decisions instead of his father taking the decisions on his behalf. Why did Subal wish to become a young child? Subal thought that while he was a child, he missed out quite a few things that he could revisit his childhood and do, and he wouldn't waste a moment in any futile actions or events. Why was Sushil not happy after he became an old man? Sushil faced several difficulties after becoming an old man. Most importantly, he was too weak to play like his friends. After becoming old, he suddenly lost his childish enthusiasm and cheerfulness. He no longer enjoyed the sports that he used to enjoy with friends. You can make out that the connectors are not given, only the idea is given to you. You need to consider these ideas and write the answer in your own words. This is the answer. And the next question, why did Subal wish to be an old man again? So Subal wanted to be an old man again because he did not like that childhood at all, where he did not enjoy that childhood which he wanted to enjoy, because his body was different and his mind was completely different, and the people around him did not accept him as such. Why did elderly people chase Subal away? The elderly people chased Subal away because they did not want a person who was looking as a child but acting as an older person, so they found him completely out of place. They found him a rude and impudent, as if misbehaved person who did not know how to behave with elderly people or older people. I hope these guidelines will help you write the answers in your notebook. Now let us proceed to an activity. The activity is to arrange the story in the sequence of occurrence of events. Now you have read the story, you have understood what happened first, what happened next, what happened after that, and then finally what happened at the end. I've given you certain pictures. What you need to do is, you need to take down the picture number, you need to give the number yourself, then the order it is occurring. And then whatever you understand from the picture, you write in front of that number. So that is your understanding of or depiction of the picture. Then you go on writing this for every picture. And you need to scroll. You need to scroll up and go back to the story and refer the events in the story. And then you need to come back to that captions or the line that you've written and give a numeral or numbering, reordering those pictures. Okay, and then you need to take that information and write it in the correct order as a paragraph, but you have to use sequential language. That means first what happened, then next, first, then next, after which, finally. If you want to bring in more words, you can say moreover, after which, all such words can be used to depict the sequence. You may use more transitional words if you desire. Now let me show you the pictures that I have selected for your activity. You need to do it online only, and you need to do it on screen. Do not print it, do not cut it into pieces, and try reordering. First of all, we have got some information regarding the author, that is Rabindranath Tagore. I want students to pause the video and read it themselves by muting it, or if you want me to read it to you, I will read it to you. Rabindranath Tagore was a famous poet and writer from India who won the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1913. He is the first non-European to win the Nobel Prize in Literature. Though most of Tagore's work was written in Bengali, originally he translated several of them to English. His most famous pieces of writing include It's a Bengali word, I believe. It's a Chor Bali, translated in 1903 to Isor and Nashtaneir, or The Broken Nest. He later wrote Gitanjali, which is an outstanding collection of songs. Some of his other well-known works include Jatri and Vichitra. A substantial part of Tagore's work was in the form of stories and articles published in local publications. His song, Our Golden Bengal, is the national anthem of Bangladesh. He also spread his ideas about life and living in this way for the benefit of others. In this process, he created an educational setup called Shanti Niketan, based on practical activities that has now flourished into a big university. His personal life as well as the activities of Shanti Niketan included things like composing music and singing, staging dramas, painting, making handicrafts, and designing and wearing new kinds of clothes for greater comfort. Now let us proceed. Gitanjali, Kabliwala, Gora, Rajeshri, these are quite a few works that are mentioned over here for your reference. Now let us see the pictures that we have. In the story titled When Wishes Come True, Rabindranath Tagore describes the strange dream of a father named Subal and his son Sushil. The first picture, I think you can mention, you can introduce your characters. You can pause and read what dialogue is going on. That will give you some hint. It might be in order, it might not be in order. If the dialogues are not visible to you, just read the top line, the caption. The top dialogues cannot be read, it's not very legible, but the pictures are quite the caption is quite legible. Again, the thought comes in. It's quite suggestive. The goddess granting wish. Of course, what is the thought? You cannot read it, but the captions can be read. Constable locked his son, Sushil, inside the and told not to go to school. This is the last picture. All the events in the story may not be given in the pictures. Enjoy reading and rearranging. Write the story with a suitable caption. Now, whatever pictures have been given to you, try revisiting those pictures. Go read the text again and arrange the pictures. Only those events to be written down where the pictures have been given to you. Enjoy arranging it, writing it. Your focus should be a caption for the paragraph. The events in order, transitional words, appropriate vocabulary for paragraph writing. The visual impetus that is given to you, it is not in the sequential order. Kindly arrange it in sequential order. If you are new on the channel, kindly subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so that you receive the notification when I upload my next video in this series. And kindly click on like so that it gets added up in your like to playlist of liked videos, so you can always revisit this video for when you are having your periodic assessments or your term 1 examinations. Thank you and have a wonderful day.